Dearest Mum, 6 years have passed since I left our Yorkshire home for Glace Bay, not a Cumberland. It's not that I lust to roam. Since the age of 13 years, I have not risen past this role. It would appear to be my destiny to dig the rich man's coal. In these deplorable conditions, men rank below the mules. So I have organized my brothers, and tomorrow we down tools. For these workings on this island, I've never toiled in dingier. On a lighter note, Mum, the lads here call me Ginger. I remain your affectionate son, Albert. Dearest Mum, since last I wrote that grim, despairing letter, my prospects went from bad to worse, but now they are much better. For I have gone from the blacklist to lead this labor movement. Even the worst worrywart would view this as improvement. However, soon we will have to strike again for a standard 8-hour day, for the right to collective bargaining, for safety and fair pay. And as this great war grinds along with workers killing others, the good news is I have black lung, thus I'm spared from fighting my brothers. I remain your affectionate son, Albert. Dearest Mum, I am so sorry, there's been no time to write. They've declared me fit for combat now, and I've taken flight. I know they've sent a posse, and thus I know I'd better not mention where I'm headed to, for fear they find this letter. Now they are upon me, I hear the branches crack. I know now how a deer must feel, each turn I turn my back. This time I must surrender, it would do no good to run. I would rather face a prison term than a bounty hunter's gun. I remain